actualizations. Five actualizations. This is a Microsoft PPT, okay, about virtualization, and it is around Hyper-V, SCCM, SEVMM, like this kind of stuff only. So types of virtualization: server, desktop, user state, presentation, network, and application virtualization. So this is about server virtualization. Create, run multiple computer operating systems on a single physical server. Host several shared resources with all virtual machines. Host server share resources with all virtual machines. What is server resources? Means CPU, RAM, disk space, and network, of course. Hosted on Microsoft Hyper-V, so because it's a Microsoft related one, they given this point. Allow you to detach a computer hosting on a service or a role from the hardware on which it is runs. So detach, attach, detach. Allow you to detach on a computer hosting a service or a role from the hardware on which it runs. Almost all server workloads can now run on virtual machines. Use server virtualization to reduce the number of physically deployed servers and to optimize physical resources. Just as we discuss, this also, these points also I will add it into my slides. Look like you have a lot of material, but still it's okay. Just for same points and again and it is repeating, just like this is a very simplified points, okay, but here it is given easy points here, but I want to explain it, so then I will go to this same explanation, but this is I explained about my desktop. But how this server virtualization means. I will put a full screen then. Here it is. I took a server. Okay, I have a machine. In this machine, one by one layer we will put it. First layer is like your hardware layer. Okay. Hardware layer means CPU, RAM, storage is your hardware layer. And on this one, required operating system. So I want to run some application, so I need a operating system. Either it is a Windows or Linux or any operating system, and I install applications as I require. Okay, applications I install. Right, so this is one system. Again, I have to run some application in different operating system. Or maybe a different machine. Again, it goes similar with this one. So I am just copying like this. Another machine. Maybe I need another machine. Okay, like this. I have to keep adding my machines depends upon my requirement. So normally, what is the cost of a machine? So we'll, in the sense, like we discuss about like a reduce the cost. So what is the cost of a machine? So what is the problem with this thing? So one is a cost. So what is the cost of a machine? So we'll see that one. Cost of a machine kind of stuff. So here it is. We are using a i3, i5, i7, Ryzen 7, Ryzen 3, Ryzen 9, like this, right? These are a desktop model processors, not server model processors. Just I want to show you the cost of a one single server. Usually, like if you want to go with the tower. Yeah, I'm going to this tower, which is very small cost, very basic model I'm going. It's a Dell powered T40 tower server. The base server with 8 GB RAM and 1 TB of hard disk, SATA hard disk. The cost is $49,050. Okay, so it is not given any CPU kind of stuff. Yeah, here it is given. Intel E224G processor. So how many cores of this processor are having? Okay, so we'll see that one also. Go to Intel. Here it is. So which model it is, how many cores are there? See, here it is, 4 core only it is, 4 threads. It is a very basic model. Okay, it is a very basic model, but you can see bus speeds, turbo speeds, virtualization enabled or not. Maximum memory support is 128 GB. i3, i5 will support up to 32, 64 only, but it is supporting 128 GB. Okay, so it's a very basic model only. And if you need anything just extra 8 GB required, you have to pay extra. 16 GB want to add, 15,000 you have to put it. 1 TB of SATA hard disk you want to add extra, again you have to give 7,000 rupees for it. This is a standard edition. And server, you have to Windows server you want to install, 61,000. Around 61,000 for a standard edition. Okay, essentials up to support 25 users, 36,000. No call, zero call, something is there, it is, I don't know, but what. Okay, so when I will add it, so then it is become this cost with the 8 GB. Not even a 16 GB, not even a 32 GB. It's a basic model. It is. You can go for this one, Think System, Lenovo Think System. This is rack server. So you can see rack. If you, this is also a tower server, but you can see it is the cost is around 1 lakh. With 8 GB like this. This is a rack. It means this is one server. Okay. And it is also 8 core processor, 16 GB RAM, 1,75,000. Starting price. If you want to add any additional, so then we have to go to keep additional kind of stuff on. So just see the cost of it. Next. So one server. If you install a server operating system, again server license you required, application you are running, so the application things we have to require. Next, how much utilizing this server resources? This is one server, each server, how much we are utilizing this server? Utilization. Guys, always remember, return on investment. The word is return on investment. For example, you purchase a bike. For example, I purchase a bike, not you. I purchase a bike and I don't know how to ride the bike also. So don't worry. Okay. And I'm riding. Now it is Corona. No need of having a bike. Yeah, best example is me only again. I purchased a bicycle in 2019 December, end of the year. and I use in January 2020, and Feb only 1 or 2 days. Then lockdown from March, no use. Again this year 2021, I went to office for 1 week. Then 5 days or 6 days I use bicycle, and then no office, and then lockdown. So still it is useless. I pay almost around 10,000 plus for that one. Okay, it is gear type bicycle with accessories and all. It cost that one. See, 10,000 rupees I use maximum of 30 to 40 days max. Useless, right? So actually my plan to reduce my traveling cost from my room to my office, it is 5 to 5.5 kilometers from here to there. Auto daily it is around 150. Okay, so 120, 130 to 150, around 150 I'm paying daily. So I want to reduce the cost, so then I purchase a bicycle because I don't know how to ride a bike. So what is my return on investment? Nothing, loss only. If I sell it, I don't get much money. Maximum I will get 1,000, 2,000 rupees max. Right? So return on investment. This is a electronic equipment. You purchase a mobile phone, laptop or desktop. If you don't use it, no use. So return on investment by using this server and you paying for 1 lakh, 2 lakh rupees for a server, and what is you are getting from it. Okay. Maximum utilization in generally e-services is not more than 20%. If it is very highly using, means e-server, maximum we can able to use 20% only. The reality is you have to utilize based on your investment at least 75%. Of course you cannot use 80-90%, but max you have to utilize 75%. But I'm utilizing maximum 20% only. If you are not utilized, it is go down to 10% only total CPU resources. Okay, so what are the service you are running? So we are running with a maximum 20% resources only we are using max. If you are using it, if you are not using it, even the just a service only, just you install a operating system, nothing you do, only 1 or 2 just services run. And we can't run more applications and services in the single server. So the cost is your return on investment is not fulfilling. If you are not utilizing much, it is become very less, right? So obviously, next, for each and type of services, you want to divide a service, you want to create a domain, or you want a different operating system, different applications, you have to deploy multiple servers. Then cost is keeping increasing. And no trust on this server. Server can be down anytime because it's an electronic device. Compulsory, you should put a failover. There's a few words are there. Compulsory, you should know it. Actually, any of the training, you start with these things. Like failover, load balancer. Example, you have a domain controller, DC. Compulsory, you required a additional domain controller, ADC. Why? If DC is failure, ADC will do the DC job, authentication job. What is the job of domain controller? Authenticate users, right? If DC is failure, who will authenticate you? Additional domain controller will authenticate you. Okay, additional domain control authenticate. So you have to require, you required a failover and load balancer. Again, the cost is keep increasing for each and every time. Now we'll go to this same thing with a virtualization. Okay, here it is, same thing as it is, just also a server. Server means it contains a hardware. It means it contains a CPU, RAM, and disk like that. System is there. Okay, next. Here, I am going to install in this server a very small kind of stuff that is called a hypervisor. Okay, check with one by one. So hypervisor, what is this hypervisor? Hypervisor is not an application, not an operating system. Hypervisor is not a application, not a operating system. It is a kind of one kind of operating system, and exactly say it is a platform. Hypervisor is a virtualization platform. Okay, hypervisor is a virtualization platform. So by using this platform, it is like we are installing, how we install operating system, like that only we install. Hypervisor contains its own kernel. Okay, hypervisor contains its own kernel. So like every operating system has a kernel, it contains a kernel. It contains a shell also, basic shell is also there. But it virtualizes virtualize your hardware resources means CPU, RAM. So it will create, this is a platform, right? So it will create a virtualization part. It uses it to create, you can create and run virtual machines. Is use it to create and run your virtual machines. I have to copy these things somewhere because I want to recopy it into our PPTs. Okay, so it is the virtualization platform. It virtualizes your hardware resources, and you can create and run virtual machines in the this server. Like we can create a virtual machines in the server. Of course, you can install an operating system here. So required operating system, which type of operating system you want to install. So we can install it. So this hypervisor virtualize this hardware, and it will provide a software defined hardware to our virtual machines. Okay, and you can install what are the application you want it. You can install applications as per the your hardware, or you can run a server. You can install a Windows server, you can install a Windows 10, or maybe you want to install a Linux, and you want to install some applications in it, you want to install some services in it, you can install it. Just for example, this is one physical machine and I'm running 3 virtual machines here. Okay, no operating system interaction is there. Okay, so how to create a virtual machine? By using remote desktops only. So you have a desktop tools. Using desktop tools, we can connect it through the network. Okay, this is normal desktop, just like our Windows 10. Okay, this is a normal desktop. Okay, like Windows 10 desktop or a Linux desktop, anything. So this is normal desktop. By connecting it, through different tools like using a web browser or desktop tools are there, so we can connect it to this. So I'll use different color for that one. Okay, we'll connect it to this and we create these virtual machines here, and we can view the virtual machine and we can access the virtual machine from it. Some more points are there, so I will tell again, but here, okay, simply understand guys, server virtualization. So we have a hardware, means it is a server, physical server. In the physical server, I put a hypervisor. I will explain types of hypervisors also. And I created a virtual machines in it. In the virtual machine, I install operating system and applications I am running. Okay. This type of virtual machine, we call it as a bare metal virtualization. Okay. This type of virtual machines, virtualization, we call it as a bare metal virtualization, and also it is called as a type 1 virtualization. Is it okay or not? Okay. So due to these pictures, then I want to add some more text in this corner. So I will put this one in this side. Okay. Here it is. This hypervisor is just a name, but originally hypervisor means like this. Okay, hypervisors from different organization. Okay, so for example, VMware providing hypervisor name is vSphere or ESXi. Both names are same. VMware is an organization. Guys, when you are doing a practicals on VMware workstation, right? That is, VMware workstation is an application, not a hypervisor. It is a hypervisor application. It is like when you install application, automatically the hypervisor is installed on your operating system. With the cooperation of operating system, you can run it. Okay, so hypervisor in the application virtualize your hardware, and the application runs on operating system. And VMware is an organization also providing different products. One of the product is VMware workstation, another product is VMware vSphere. At present, lot of products are there. Okay, for example, Windows means Microsoft. We should not say Windows here. This Windows is also there, but Microsoft hypervisor is Hyper-V. Citrix is an organization giving this hypervisor is a Xen server. The hypervisor name is Xen server. One more is there, that is open source hypervisor is also there, Proxmox is a open source free virtualization. There is a one or two products in there, Proxmox virtualization environment, email gateway, and one or two products are there. So Proxmox VE is a virtualization one. It's a free one. Anybody can use it. It is a very lightweight 2GB RAM. With the 2GB RAM also, you can able to install it. Mm-hmm. I will tell the conditions also to install a virtualization kind of stuff. Wire. Okay, so this is also there. So these are all providing a hypervisor platforms with the different names and kind of stuff. Okay, so this is type 1 virtualization, bare metal virtualization, and hypervisor we installed. So then we can create and run virtual machines in that one. So different type of virtual hypervisors are there. Okay. So from VMware vSphere, Microsoft Hyper-V, Citrix Zen Server, Proxmox, Proxmox VE. Out of this one, I like, I don't like Citrix. I tried Citrix, but the uploading of files from local machine is difficult. Remaining is okay. Hyper-V is physically deployed. Labs are there, like 4 or 5 machines are there, then it is okay. We can enjoy, but in virtualization environment and all, it is very difficult to manage. Means not a lot of options. But it's okay. In your syllabus, only 2 are there. That is these 2 things. So we do practicals on vSphere 7. Current version is 7. Okay. And current version is Hyper-V is 2019. Current version is 2019 and it is a 7. So we have a practicals on it. So we'll see how to do the practical also. So here where I written. So of course we can try find what is hypervisor in the there. I given a very short notes instead of big notes. So then I given a very short notes here. Okay. And also this. This is your different hypervisors. This is separate. So is it a text is different or this is okay? Yeah, what is this? Okay. Sai processor is good with these things. Like when he teach, he will create a PPT directly. So he never worries about what it is like that. I choose to type on a Okay, so here it is. This is a picture. I took it from Saravan only, and of course, if you search in Google, also you will find it. Traditional architecture, like this is the machine, operating system, application you are installing. But if you see here, it is virtual architecture. Here is a machine, virtualization layer, and these are virtual machines, multiple virtual machines. Install operating system in it, and install a application on it. Okay. So these are just already we told that one. And we have a type 1 and type 2 virtualization. So we'll go to that one also. I want to save this picture. Okay. Type 1, type 2 is not a different thing, but just it is same like. This is a type 1 virtualization. Then what is type 2 virtualization? That's the only difference. Again, I have to draw everything. Okay, so this is a server. Again, I split the parts like this and like this. Why this is coming? Keep coming. What happening? So this is my hardware, like CPU, RAM, disk. What is there? Hypervisor. Okay, any hypervisor. And I create a virtual machines here. Okay. Like this virtual machines. Okay. I didn't explain one more point here is there. So I will explain it. So app OS, okay. So this is I told type 1 virtualization. Next, this what type of virtualization said, I said bare metal virtualization. Bare metal virtualization. Again, I'm telling other side. Okay. In this one, hypervisors. Different type of hypervisors are there. From like I can copy paste. Then I will become lazy. Of course, now all of them at present. Okay, this is your type 1 virtualization. Now, what is type 2 virtualization? Type 1 I told again and again I'm telling, but type 2 virtualization. Of course, Linux KVM is also there. Okay, so here one more point I forget to add, that is. From enterprise Linux, for example, Red Hat is providing one kind of virtualization that is called a Red Hat Enterprise Virtualization. Oh, it has become big. Okay, so in bracket RHEV. Of course, Linux, which means Red Hat Linux or any Linux like CentOS is also giving. Oracle Enterprise Linux, any Enterprise Linux. One more kind of virtualization is there, KVM slash QEMU. It comes with your operating system, not as a direct one. Just like this is a special case, is there. Here it is. We can't consider that is type 1 or a type 2 thing. Like you have a Windows servers 2008 onwards, 2008 64-bit onwards, along with your operating system you are getting Hyper-V also. Hyper-V alone and along with this one also you are getting of course Windows 8 64-bit onwards. Some people tell from Windows 7 onwards, still I don't understand. I didn't find Hyper-V in that one. Virtualization is there in Windows 7, but virtualization is there in Windows 7, but actually Hyper-V in a professional or enterprise edition onwards, Hyper-V is giving with the operating system. B is always caps. Okay. So this particular thing is not a exactly type 1 or a type 2 part. So I will tell type 2, so don't worry. Yeah, it is machine. So when we call a something like a type 1, okay, so type 1 means virtualization, hypervisor platform is directly interact with your hardware, not with your operating system. So that we call it as a type 1 always. So like that, we can consider these things as a type 1 virtualization only, irrespective of what operating system status, so it will run. So we'll go to the type 2. Same machine, you have a hardware like a CPU, you have a resources like RAM and storage, disk space is there. But in type 2, so my laptop is currently it's a type 2 virtualization. Okay, so type 2 is contains operating system. Anything Windows or Linux operating system. Okay, so you can have a Windows, Linux, Mac, anything. So operating system can be Windows, Linux, Mac. What is Mac? Apple. Okay, so any operating system can be there. And we have an application. Hypervisor based application. Here is a not direct hypervisor, it is based on application only. Using this application, we can create multiple virtual machines inside. We can create a VMs here. In these VMs, again, we can install a operating system. These operating systems, we call it as a guest operating system. Physical machine OS is a OS and operating system running on a virtual machine. Whatever the type of virtual machine it is what type of what type of virtualization you are doing. So that is the OS in the virtual machine, either here or here. Okay, either here or there, OS is a guest operating system only. So this type of virtualization is type 2 virtualization. But what is this application? What is this hypervisor application? Again, this is blocking my view, so I'll keep it here. This application means runs on operating system. Compulsory, you require operating system. In operating system, you are installing an application. Using that application, we are accessing this one. So from VMware, okay, VMware workstation. VMware, from VMware, VMware workstation. From Oracle VirtualBox. VirtualBox is a free edition. Okay, there is a free edition in the VMware also there. That is called Player. The Player is also free edition from VMware. Workstation is a paid version. You have to pay to use it. Okay. Player is a free version from the VMware. Difference is features, certain features, but both are same. VirtualBox is a free from version from there, and currently not using one is also that is called from Microsoft. Virtual PC from Microsoft. I don't have a space here, so I have to reduce the space or bokeh to visible, right? VMware workstation or a player, Oracle virtual box and Microsoft virtual PC. So these are a type 2 virtualizations. So type 2 virtualization depends upon your hardware, operating system and an application. Through application we can able to do it. Like I have a Windows 10 machine, but home edition, no Hyper-V. So what I done? So I install Oracle VirtualBox and VMware workstation. Then I'm creating virtual machines in that one. I'm using it. So this is more like a desktop virtualization kind of stuff. So I will explain desktop virtualization. Then again, these points will come up. So don't worry. Understand, guys? Type 1 and type 2 virtualization. A nice picture, right? Better to save it. I lost my voice, so sad. I didn't know internet disconnection, nothing. From morning onwards, it is a problem. ఇంటర్నెట్ దొబ్బిందా? అక్కడ ఏం చూపించట్లేదు, అక్కడ ఏమి చూపించట్లేదు. ఓకే, సో 1 సెకండ్, ఐ విల్ పాజ్ దిస్ రికార్డ్. వెన్ ఐ పాజ్డ్ ఇట్ అండ్ ఐ డోంట్ నో వెన్ ఐ పాజ్డ్ ఇట్, స్టిల్ ఐ డోంట్ రిమెంబర్. ఓకే, జస్ట్ సేక్ ఆఫ్ వీడియో దెన్ విల్ గో. సో ఎనీవే, ఐ టు రిపీట్ దిస్ వన్ రైట్. సో సర్వర్ వర్చువలైజేషన్ పార్ట్, జస్ట్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు రిపీట్ వన్స్ అగైన్, నాట్ ఎ డెప్త్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. ఓకే, ఇట్ ఇస్ స్పాయిల్డ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. ఇస్ ఎనేబుల్ మల్టిపుల్ ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ టు రన్ ఆన్ ఎ సింగిల్ సర్వర్, ద ఫిజికల్ సర్వర్, సింగిల్ ఫిజికల్ సర్వర్ యాజ్ ఎ హైలీ ఎఫిషియంట్ వర్చువల్ మెషిన్స్. ఓకే, సో సింగిల్ సర్వర్ వీ కెన్ రన్ multiple virtual machines. So what are the benefits are greater IT efficiency, reduce the operating cost, faster workload deployments, increase application performance, higher server availability, eliminates the server sprawl and complexity. If you see here it is, for each time I have to purchase a new data center or a new server kind of stuff, and then we have to install operating system and I have to install the application on it. So like that, for every requirement, so I have to go with a new server. Even for a basic requirement is also, I need a new fresh server is required. But using this virtualization concept, I have a server and I install a hypervisor, and using hypervisor, I can install a multiple, I can create a multiple virtual machines. In that one, I can install operating system, and in that one, I can run the applications. So in the one single server, I can run multiple machines. In the single server, I can run multiple machines. Of course, there is a hardware limitation is there. Number of machines limitations also there. So this is about your server virtualization again. Server virtualization also called as a bare metal virtualization. We install a hypervisor in the server. Okay, different type of hypervisors are there, depends upon the different organization giving. For example, VMware, so vSphere, ESXi, latest version is 7. Okay, so Microsoft is giving a Hyper-V, Citrix, Xen server. So guys, check what is the latest version of Citrix Xen server. Proxmox is a open source virtualization platform, so anybody can able to use it. If you want to develop, and you can download and develop just like you Linux only, like how you take a Linux and develop, that kind of stuff only. Source code is free, you can download a source code also. Next, I type 1 and type 2 virtualizations. In a type 1 virtualization is a bare metal virtualization, so hypervisor is installed on, directly installed on your hardware. Okay, so this will create a virtualize your hardware, so then we can create a virtual machines. Of course, virtualization thing is also there along with operating system, means you have a operating system plus bare metal virtualization, like a Hyper-V and KVM kind of stuff is there in a Windows servers and Windows desktop operating systems like Windows 8 Pro and Enterprises 2008 64-bit onwards, means 2012 2016 2019 2022, next upcoming operating system, like any enterprise Linux, like a Red Hat 6, Red Hat 7 or a CentOS 6.7, you will get a KVM, QEMV platform for a virtualization purpose. Next one is type 2 virtualization. Latest is version 7.1 for a VMware or Citrix. Next one is type 2 virtualization. Type 2 virtualization more like a desktop virtualization, means in a client desktop, means in my desktop, I can create, is already operating system is there,
So I need a virtualization concept, like I want to create a virtual machine. Yeah, for example, sir. Okay, it is a 7.1. Okay, so he given it is a latest version is so 7.1. We have to cover both the things, like both interview questions also. Just maybe they will ask like while you're speaking it. At the time of interview, this thing will maybe changes, or at the time of you are writing a test, better to check it. Okay. So actually it is a 7.0.1 something is there. 0.1 or 0.2 something is there. Update U, update A kind of stuff is there, but it's around 7. So don't go with the zero kind of stuff, or maybe go. This is current version is 2019. Build version, I didn't check the build version, but it is 2019. You want to download Hyper-V, directly you can download Core Hyper-V. This version, not it. So we'll see again. We'll update that one. So you need an application like VMware Workstation or a Player. Workstation is a paid version, Player is a free version, Oracle VirtualBox. Microsoft Virtual PC only works in a Windows XP 7 Vista only, but not works in a Windows 8. This is only for a Vista Windows 7 purpose. Okay, so XP, Vista, Windows 7, Virtual PCs works. Okay. It is one example of desktop virtualization. Means in a client side, in a client desktop, you can, if you want a virtual machines to run in the client desktop, we need an application, and it runs, application runs on your operating system, and application provide a hypervisor part, and then we can run a, we can create a virtual machine, install a operating system, install a applications, but it is not centralized one. Okay, type 2 is a, not a centralized one. Type 1 is centralized virtualization. Here it is like how to create a virtual machines when you want to create a virtual machine in a type 1 server virtualization. Okay, in the server, so we don't get a much user interface, very basic user interface you will get it, and we cannot create or view virtual machines in that user interface. Only basic administration is available, only basic administration is available. So different server hypervisor having a different kind of interfaces. For example, VMware vSphere. vSphere client is a desktop tool. You can install in your desktop and you can access it, or you can access from 6.7 using a web browser. Okay, it is a web client, web access. So then we can connect it to a remote server through web browser, access username, password, and you can manage, view, create virtual machine, run virtual machine, like that. In a Hyper-V type, in a Hyper-V, so the desktop, in the desktop, we require Hyper-V manager, PowerShell, or a Windows admin center should be installed in your remote PC. So then we can access from the client with a web browser. Xen server is not a Xen desktop. There is a mistake. Why I type Xen desktop? It is a Xen center. Xen server. Xen center. Which one is there? Which one is here? Sorry. It's a Xen center. Xen center setup. Xen center. Xen server is a different. So why I done this mistake? Oh, shit. How to change this one? Yes, it. Okay. Insert. Center. I in my mind it is there. Maybe that time it is already 5:30. Our brain is only work, right? Okay. No. This ball and increase the text and replace this thing with here. It is not replacing. It's okay. I will put it here. Then center. So yeah, my mind is very faster and this today, so I done a mistake there. Sorry guys, it is a big mistake. Okay, it's a Xen Center. Sorry, Proxmox we also web client, so we can connect it to our remote server, and we can create our virtual machines, and also we can manage our server, both networking, storage, and virtual machines, accessing virtual machines, which user can access, like that we can do it. Of course, when you create a virtual machines, you have to access remotely. So using different protocols, we can access this virtual machine to the by user or a client. Okay, like generally Windows means RDP, remote desktop protocols we are using. Telnet, SSH, using a PuTTY is an application, or a direct connected with the SSH telnet from your desktop tools. Any tools, PuTTY is a famous one. Okay, so PowerShell, we can connect it using PowerShell also. We can connect if it is a Windows, okay, if it is having PowerShell thing. VNC type, Tiger VNC, Real VNC kind of stuff also we can do it. So different type of things like a Hyper-V, vSphere, Xen Server also giving remote connecting tools also there for things like VMRC tools, example. Okay. That's it. So that's only we discuss. Okay. So this is not Xen Desktop. Xen Desktop is desktop virtualization related one. Xen Center is remote access tool, okay, desktop tool. You can use web browser also for Xen, and I don't like it. Yeah, that's it, right? So you guys are already exhausted.